because I have no cat picture. Wow, that's a fabulous start. Right, ECML London to Peterborough. Let's go with the 66. Oh yeah, there you go. Class 66 cab. And I've still got my fan switched off. There we go. We'll get organised one of these days. So what's coming up? Class 67 on London Peterborough. Someone requested the class 67, so here it is. Then we're going to hop over to Germany, do the BR189 on Hamburg-Hanover, the Marschen mix-up. Then we're going to fly over to America and do some Donner Pass, a new workshop scenario that Mr. Dole's always uploaded, SP choked. And if we have time, if time is going well, we'll see if we can sneak in a fourth one back in Germany again with some S-Bahn trains, given that these are all freight trains. We need a little bit of passenger goodness. Welcome to the channel, everybody. We've got 9209, Darkness Monster, Dave, Sapphire, Marcus, and Tom Overshoe. Welcome, welcome. What scenario am I doing the skip? I am doing Through the Middle Part 1, which is a workshop scenario downloaded, and it's uploaded by Selle61, S-E-L-L-E-S-O-1. Your approach to Peterborough with this class 67 as a substitute for an unavailable class 66. No delays are reported, but you should expect some minor delays when running through Peterborough. The maximum speed of this train is 75. Horn sounds familiar. It's time for wipers. Headlights! Feel like I'm forgetting something here. Oh no, it's just a heavy train. Got no brakes on anywhere. Welcome, Steve. Fire away, Louis. I will do my best to answer it for you. I have not driven this train in a really long time. Everything's on release. Is it just a heavy train? Must be. Decent cab though. Hey. Hey, Grim Sleeper, welcome to the channel this evening. I just realised I haven't even got the Twitch window open tonight. What's going on? Dashboard. What load is behind? Bunch of containers by the looks of it. I like how the signal is predicting we're going to get a red signal. That's excellent. Dave, yeah, that was exactly what I thought, what you said. Sorry I wasn't clear. So I just wanted to make sure that all the screenshots that are sent in and used get properly attributed so people know where they've come from. Louis, there are books with train gradient profiles in, and there is network rail documentation, which is a bit hard to get hold of, which has gradient profile information. But if you look around, there's one called BR Mainline Gradient Profiles is the name of the book. It's quite hard to get hold of now, but if you can find it, that's got quite a lot of gradient information in it. Right, we haven't updated the Twitch channel. What have we got tonight? I'm going to put all of it in one go. So, class 67. Hey, Hugo, welcome. And Spikey, welcome. Oh, hello. Another freight train went past there. thank you. I put a new logo on the channel, various social media places, not everywhere yet. I only just did it. I got me crayons out. What is the schedule for tonight? The schedule for tonight is Class 67 on London to Peterborough, BR189 on Hamburg Hanover. I think it's the SD45 on Donner Pass. And then, if time permits, maybe a bit of BR426 over on the Munich-Garmisch line. Hey, Francesco. Thanks for joining. I haven't a clue, Spikey, I'm afraid. There is, of course, a bit of DLC on sale at the moment as part of the Train Sim festivals. Details on engine driver. Sapphire, I will just paste my email address in. If you send screenshots to there, I will review them and see what I can use on the the screensavers while I'm changing route. Feel free to put a credit, put your username or whatever, however you would like to be known on the on there. I do want people to get credit for their work. Good evening, Ricky. Louis, if it's your first route that you're trying to do even remotely accurately, then I would definitely suggest do something very short. Even as little as a mile long. Whoa, something's making my machine grind tonight. Yeah, so, something very short just to start off with. Oh, hello. Squeaky, squeaky, squeak. Oh, hang on, that's probably just for the 105. We're nowhere near 105. Do something short. It's, what you'll find is that it's actually more work than you can even possibly imagine at the moment, just to get 1 mile populated well. So do 1 mile, and then you'll understand it, and then you'll be able to work out, having done a mile, what you think you can realistically achieve. I'm a little bit nervous about the fact that the route, the time to destination, isn't going down. Oh well. We'll get there eventually, I'm sure. So dem data you need to download from a website. I'll leave it to you, go and find a website to get the appropriate data. So you will probably want SRTM or ASTA, are the two formats that are formatted. Find the data and then go into the Railworks folder and create a folder called dem. And inside that, if you're using SRTM data, I think you create a folder called SRTM. put the data files in there, the height files, and then when you go in the game, the in the root editor, there is a button on the top left flyout, which will then, you just say, do you want to import a 3x3 grid or a 4x4 grid, and it will then import that data from the height files. To be honest, it's a bit, unless I'm actually going to cover it and do a specific tutorial on it, it's a bit difficult to describe because it's quite visual. But there are a lot of tutorials. I followed some of them to sort of sort it out myself in the past. So if you do a Google search, you will find them. At some point, as part of the root building series of tutorials, I am going to cover that though. Welcome, MV68. Pezzawalk. Oh wow, I've missed loads. Ricky, Frosty, Mega Steve, Pezzawalk, Hostpipe Mike. MB68 and ECML123, welcome. I think they said the maximum speed for this train was supposed to be 75. Oops. Hey Russell, welcome. Hey Spikey, I'm not ignoring you, I just can't really comment on the pricing stuff. Sorry. Louis, if you have a problem with the Google Maps, there are two things you need to check. First one is to go onto the Google Maps control panel and make sure that static maps are enabled. If static maps are enabled, then in every other case I've solved this problem, it is still down to that API key. So what you need to do is copy and paste it from the web page that you get the key from onto Notepad. Then make the font really big so that you can see it very, very clearly. And then carefully type it in. I've seen people where they've retyped it in 3 or 4 times and it still said it's not working. And then when I've gone over it, it's always been something like a capital letter's wrong, or an I instead of a J, or an L instead of a 1. You've really, really got to be careful, because anything wrong on that key, and it just won't work. And it won't say anything either, it'll just not work. And it is important that you paste it into something like Notepad first, because the font that you get on the web page in most browsers for that website mixes up L's and 1's. And I think a couple of others like O's and zeros. So so you can't go by the website when you're typing it in, because you won't know those things apart. So paste it into Notepad and then really, really, really be careful. It does work. I think Dovetail use it every day as part of the root building. Yeah, unfortunately, Sapphire, you can't cut and paste in Tiers 15. You could in 14, but you can't in 15. That'll make all our lives so much easier. The only thing you can do with the maps 92009 is there's one that says the there's a tile zoom level. So if you zoom the tiles in, you get smaller tiles, but they've got a lot more detail on them. And if you then do, say, a 6x6 grid, then you'll get that over a bigger period. But obviously, what you're going to get is significantly more data downloading, so it's going to take more time. And also, once you've got your API key set up, then you can switch over to the higher definition. There's two options. I can't remember what the resolutions are, but if you switch to the higher one, you get better maps there too. Hey, Moose, welcome. Freightliner 66. There's a lot of containers moving about on the East Coast Main Line on this scenario. Hey Jim Binks, when I know that I'm going to show how to do it correctly, is the bottom line. I've got a lot of the different bits and pieces that need to be done, sorted out, but we're just sort of getting the last bits and then I'll be there. So bear with me. We're not there yet, but we will be. Russell, what's planned for the evening? ECML London to Peterborough with a Class 67. that's this, followed by HSD going past, followed by BR189 on Hamburg Hanover running the Marsh End mix-up scenario, then over to Donner Pass to run a workshop scenario called SB Choat. I know the name is cool. And then if we have time, and I don't know if we will, but if we have time, then we'll do a fourth scenario in on the Munich Garmisch line. Since these three are all freight, that'll be a little bit of passenger traffic. Hey Gazza, thanks for joining, much appreciated. Following. Where's a good place to do some train spotting? Nowhere sensible. All right, let's just sit down on the side here. Don't do this at home, boys and girls. Nope, this one's a freight train. Yes, I have heard that drumbeat or something certainly to that effect. Oh, it's the another 67 going. Oh, top and tail 67. Excellent. Executive train, probably. Well, that doesn't do very much. It's all about mastering your machines, Jesse. It's all about mastering your machines. Notch up! Now I've mastered my machine. Yay! Yeah, something's not quite right with this scenario, I don't think. Either that or it'll fix itself later on, because this thing isn't going down. Either that or I've missed a manual point that I should have set, or... We're still going down the main line. Where is this stop at red signal, then? Missing all the trains, that's no fun. Yeah, we'll get there when we get there. What level am I? Oh, in train sim, I don't know, 23, 24, something like that. That's just not a satisfying horn for when I'm going along at this sort of speed. It says I'm 5. I'm a bit more than 5. My XP is about 40,000. Cut the throttle back a little bit. Oh, I can cut it back again because we're going downhill. So while we're sitting here watching the trains, the tracks go by, don't forget YouTube. A couple of people have forgotten that any previous broadcasts that you might have missed, they're all there on YouTube. Details, of course, are up there, as are Facebook and Twitter. And don't forget to press follow down there. TS Festival. If you have a look at the Engine Driver article, you will find out everything that you would ever want to know about the TS Festivals. Essentially, it's just a way of celebrating the content on particular areas. In this particular case, it's on Germany, Munich, Augsburg particularly. Oh, I've got a yellow light. And then making that DLC cheaper so that it's easy for everyone to sort of join in and understand and read about the trains and have a go at themselves and participate in various things that are going on. So that's kind of it, but the Engine Driver article certainly sums it up a lot better. Hey Karma, how are you? There you go, Spikey. It does eventually, it will work. It's just that really so easy to make mistakes on those keys. Oh, we're getting routed left. We've got a 40 limit coming up, so I'm just going to squeeze on some brakes. Have I done a vid on the 220? I have indeed, Mike. It was done yesterday, but the video only went up sort of around lunchtime today, so you'll find it there now. Come on, slow down. Where are we now? We appear to have plenty of green lights in front of us. Welcome, Sander. I'm sure we'll be doing more videos on the 220. Get some good workshop scenarios up for it. We're in a 70 now, I can speed back up again. Hey, Bradaboss, welcome. Good to see you again. It's me, Spolder. And there's another one I can't say. Sogra Friak, welcome, with the funny username. Hey Dobbs Yobs, I didn't see you log in. Welcome. So while I've got a few of you as a captive audience, what do you think about Stories of Forest Rail? Do we want to do a run down the branch line in a future show? It's another sort of 80 odd minute scenario, same as the one down the main line, but quite different scenery because you've got the bridges and tunnels and things. Or have we seen our fill of that route? I don't want to bore people. Welcome back, Seagood. It appears the rain has stopped. Okay. Not having any no's, so I will make sure that gets added to the list for a future show. Quite fancy doing the other one, just for completeness, if nothing else. Thanks for the follow there, username I can't pronounce. it's much appreciated, even if it doesn't seem like it with the way that I speak. Where's me train? Oh, hello, gates are going down. Gates have gone down. That was rather fun. Yeah, train spot of you, it's what it's all about. It's a great way to see the trains. Follow down the track. And enjoy them from a whole different perspective instead of staying in the cab all the time. Of course, when there's no nice places to spot, you know, you just sit there, oh, hello. But that'll do. There's something coming that way. We do. See, this is what it's all about. Hello, train coming the other way as well. Ah, we've hit pay dirt here. If only I could have got a screenshot of that. Never mind. Back up to 70. Oh, hello, the distance is going down now. Hey, excellent. Hey there, good pay, Ned. Welcome. I'm being overtaken. I guess I'm allowed to be overtaken. I shouldn't take too much offence. Oh, awesome. Nice bit of AI traffic. No, I'm not going to catch that train. I'm only allowed to do 75. More freight liner goodies. Goodness. ALMKDU9Z and JP4712. It's the onslaught of the letter and number brigade. Welcome to the channel this evening. Good to have you with us. This is Through the Middle, Part 1, from Workshop. It's by Cell 601, S-E-L-L-E 601, Class 67 on London to Peterborough. This is the sort of the easier bit. There's apparently the second part is a bit harder. It's a fairly well a straight run, except for we got diverted, which meant we had to slow down. How long does the scenario take? It was about a 50-minute scenario, and we're quite a way into it now. I've only got 17 miles to go, so not long. I tried to stay under an hour per scenario. Many years ago, ECML 123, many years ago, it's on my to-do list to take myself and the family up there again at some point, but maybe this year, actually. We're not going on holiday this year, so... Yes, Ricky, I don't have a cab, a green screen cab of the 67. Hey there, Daily. Welcome back. Yeah, perfect. I'm going to give that one a run first, Steve, just to make sure that I get the hang of the timings of things correctly. I don't want to make another mess of it like I did the last one. No, I haven't been to Swindon Museum yet. What does this scenario require apart from the skip? I couldn't tell you off the top of my head. That's a few bits. That's probably not very useful, is it? If you just do a search for Through the Middle, you'll be able to find it. It was one of the first things that came up in the search results on Steam Workshop. Welcome back, Frosty. No sneamers today, Ed. Which is actually something that needs fixing. I need to do that Steam Day. Maybe I'll try and plan that Steam Day for Thursday, because tomorrow is Festival Day. So maybe I'll see if I can plan Thursday, possibly Friday, as the Steam Day. Just have a day, or show at least, dedicated to Steam. Ah, nice one, Ricky. Take lots of pictures. I'm going to find that out tomorrow morning, Ed. Basically, it'll be running a scenario and talking about the different pieces of DLC, the locos, how you can use them. I'd probably guess about sort of 30 to 45 minutes long, similar to the 378 preview. Thanks, Dart, for posting that. Much appreciated. A single red all of a sudden. Single amber, sorry. Single red would be rather more fatal. We've got an amber there. I'm sure that was a single amber that just went past. UK Chinese team did an exhibition at the Shildon Museum, Dave, but unfortunately that particular time I wasn't actually able to go, so I haven't been, but I have seen lots of photographs. Hey there, Metro, welcome. Hey Panda 1967, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. I can't trust these signals now. In theory, this next one's a red, but then so is the last one going to be a red. Get the binoculars out, see if we can't see this signal. Work out what we're going to do. Welcome to the chat, Panda. Got to assume this thing is a red, so I need to make sure I can stop until I can see otherwise. Hey, 365. Oh, wow, that signal's around all the corners, and now it's green. There you go, Ed. Make me a nice steam freight scenario. But I will practice repeatedly until I get it right, rather than embarrass myself again. Welcome, Captain Cheesecake and Marcus Lee. Making me hungry, Captain Cheesecake. Eleven and a half miles to go. So what other train sim streams do you guys recommend? What's good train sim streams to watch? Hey, Yorix and Sir Carlos, welcome. Now, there's other people out there that do train sim streams. I can't be the only one. If I am, that's kind of cool, but... The mirrors, Metrorail fan, they are for driver-only operations. So what they do is they allow the driver to stick his head out the window, look at the mirrors, and then that allows him to see all the way down the train to make sure that all the doors are closed and passengers are clear of the doors so that they can safely leave. Previously, you'd need a guard who would check everything and then buzz the driver to let him know he's okay to go. So if you see a reference to DOO or driver-only operation, that's basically what that's to see. Hey, Charlie P. Roberts, welcome. Yes, QWERTY Afro, that's a good shout, Metro. I catch up with the squirrel stream every now and again. Yes, Dark, absolutely. Welcome back, Russell. Oh, yes. Stephen Kiberton. All right, I'll make a note of these names and check some of them out. I know I missed a whistleboard. That's because this horn is so uninspiring. Hey, Tornado Ben, welcome. Dave, to answer your question, even though they've got another one of these single yellows again, even though GNER don't actually trade as an entity on the railways, believe it or not, they still exist. They are owned by, who are they owned by? Sea Containers, along with the Pullman brand. And non-trivial to get access to them, I'm afraid. There's also the original founder of the GNER is doing his own new rail company. If you haven't heard that already, they're doing the West East Coast and West Coast, and I believe they've got ownership of the brand, but they're not interested in doing anything with the old brand. So, yes, it's a shame, but. Have to respect the owner's rights. quite interesting looking at licenses and how the brands move around. Because even those that are really old and don't seem connected at all, so going over to America, you've got brands like Penn Central and New York, New Haven and Hartford Railway. That's what I was trying to think of. And so those railroads don't exist in any form at all. So you'd think they would have gone by the wayside, but they actually haven't. They're owned by an insurance company. It's very strange. Francisco, I wouldn't like to comment. Just leave that one there, I think. I think I've been on the rail campsite ECML. It was a while ago now. I'll have to renew it. Remind me the URL, and I'll make sure, make an effort to go and take a look tomorrow. That's down to the asset spiking, different platforms. So there are invisible platforms. The idea being that the way that Dovetail make routes is some of the platforms are actually custom built assets in the 3D modeling system, the 3D studio. And then because you've already got the asset as the platform, in order to lay something that works for passengers and so forth, you then lay an invisible platform essentially in the same place. So that's possibly what you're seeing. So if you have a look around at other routes and their assets, particularly some of the older ones, they still have the locked platforms where you lay the platform and it sort of stretches the same way the track does. Thanks for the URL 92009. I will go and take a look. Miles to our stopping point. You'll find the platforms in the same place, and I can't remember exactly which tab you'll find them under in the route editor, but you will find them somewhere in there. That's probably not very helpful, but without a visual aid I can't help, I'm afraid. But if you try starting with some of the older routes and find them there, and then you can see if you can find them in the newer routes. Some of the newer routes may not even have those kinds of platforms, so they may only have the invisibles. But it'll be in the same place as your invisible platforms if you've got them. Welcome back, Speedy. Yeah, so presumably, Spikey, you're using assets from from one of the pre-built routes, though, or are you creating all your own assets? AC Good, I used to read the forums all the time. I just don't post anymore because whenever I post, people jump on me. Like everything's my fault. All the good and all the bad. It's not. Metro companies are really protective of their brands because it represents who they are. And so they want to be very careful about whether brands get misused. And they can't necessarily predict how something would be used. So what might seem like free advertising, and then you see all of a sudden a bunch of people crashing their trains on YouTube, and then what the news channels would do if they get hold of that. So that's sort of some of the things that they're concerned about. And to be honest, it's that old thing where it's just no one ever got fired for saying no to a risk. So it's just a lot easier for them to, for companies to say no, because it's not important. It's not important for them anyway. So some say yes, and I think they we have a really good relationship with those. I can completely understand why those that aren't sure sort of don't. Like I said, it's important that we respect that. It's their property, and wouldn't like to see our name or anything, your name plastered up on someone's thing without your permission. It's basically exactly the same thing. It's important to respect that property. Hey there, Voyager and P28 Eagle. Ooh, squeak, squeak. Ah, yes, see, dark, but fundamentally, people in licensing are not risk takers, quite the opposite. End of part one, you can pick this train up in part two of this scenario, which we're not playing tonight. We'll play that another night. That wasn't bad, I quite enjoyed that. It was a nice simple run in the 67. It's good to take that one out for a run. Catching up on the chat, what are folks saying? Ricky is probably around 100 now. It's quite a big company now.